read the guidelines once. The presentation should be of only 6 minutes. I now call upon Vijay Karthik, who is presenting a case of congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Please welcome him.
Good morning, everyone. I am Vijay Karthik from Guntur Medical College, presenting you a case of congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Coming to the patient particulars, 18-year-old Bhavani, who claims herself to be female, resident of Nuzividu, Krishna district, came with chief complaints of amenorrhea, excessive hair, and masculine voice. Now, coming down to amenorrhea, she had an episode of spotting at age of 14 years, which we consider it as menarche. After 2 years of menarche, she had another episode of spotting with progesterone challenge test. Duration of amenorrhea is 2 years, and it is not associated with any cyclical breast tenderness. There is neither cyclical pain abdomen nor any associated galactorrhea. And further probing into history, there is no history of any drug intake such as antipsychotics. Excessive hair, and especially the masculine distribution of excessive hair, seems to trouble her. And it is of duration 4 years, and there is no associated acne. Masculine voice, she has been observing deep, coarse masculine voice since 3 years. And coming to past medical history, I have taken this to exclude the other common causes of amenorrhea, and there is nothing forthcoming. At the age of 16, she was given progesterone challenge test at the private hospital, and she got meager spotting with that. And coming to personal history, everything is normal. Weekly removal of facial hair, excessive hair, seems to be her habit. Coming to family history, she has a normal younger female sibling who has attained menarche and is having regular cycles, and there is second degree consanguinity in their parents, and there is no similar complaint in the family. Coming to on general examination, she has a height of 133 centimeters, which is definitely short for her age, and weight was 31 kgs and arm spanning of 134 centimeters. On Tanner staging, breast was of Tanner stage 1, and pubic hair was of Tanner stage 4. This is the image of height 132 centimeters. And on elaborate Ferriman-Galway scoring system for hirsutism, where we grade from 0 to 4 at 9 parts of body, she had a score of 26. Anything above 8 is considered significant and is considered as hirsutism. This is the axillary hair and hair over the chest. And this is the facial hair, coarse terminal pubic hair, and hair over abdomen. And coming to gynecological examination, normal external genitalia was seen, and the hymen was visualized, and marked clitoromegaly with a clitoral index of 250 millimeters square was observed. On perirectal examination, a hypoplastic uterus was felt. This is the clitoromegaly. And on evaluating the general condition, the BP was consistently on a lower side with 90 by 60 millimeters of mercury, and these are the routine investigations for her, and her serum electrolytes were normal. On special investigations, on karyotyping, she had a normal female karyotype, 46XX. And on ultrasonography, these are the uterine measurements and considered hypoplastic. Ovaries were normal and visualized. And coming to the bone age, it corresponded to chronological age. And CT abdomen showed bilateral adrenal hyperplasia, which is very crucial for our diagnosis. These are the images showing CT, and I have put a red dot wherever adrenal hyperplasia, diffuse adrenal hyperplasia is seen. These are the axial views showing adrenal hyperplasia above the upper pole of kidney. And coming to the hormone lasses, her thyroid profile and gonadotropin's profile were normal. And coming to the important hormone lasses of gonadal hormones and cortical hormones, these are very important. Estradiol, though was normal, it was in an environment of excessive testosterone. And coming to the cortical hormones, DHEA, DHEAS, which are both diagnostic and prognostic, are elevated in cortical hormones. DHEA was elevated about 3 times, and DHEAS was about 4 times, and 17-hydroxyprogesterone, which was elevated, which clinched our diagnosis of 21-hydroxylase deficiency. Cortisol was reduced very much. And this is the image showing the blockade at 21-hydroxylase, where 17-hydroxyprogesterone upstream to is are blocked and elevated and diverting to androgens. And diagnosis is congenital adrenal hyperplasia due to 21-hydroxylase deficiency presenting age is adult age, and type of it is non-classical late onset. And treatment, coming to the treatment, most of important treatment is counseling. We have counseled the patient to understand, educated and to understand her disease. And coming to the treatment part, tablet hydrocorticoisone 10 milligrams, one in the morning, half tablet in the evening is given, tablet calcium OD. And the differential diagnosis included Turner syndrome, Cushing syndrome, aromatase deficiency, 17-20 lyase deficiency, 17 hydroxylase and 11 hydroxylase deficiencies. And following up, we are following up the patient monthly with hormone lessons to assess the treatment and regression of symptoms. And coming to the prognosis, short stage and infertility are common. And therapeutic monitoring of corticosteroids is essential for good prognosis. Stress doses of glucocorticoids, especially in times of illness, trauma, surgery, are important for, and it will be life-saving. With adequate therapy, the prognosis is usually good. However, problems with psychological adjustment is common. I thank you for providing this opportunity. It was actually 2 years after menarche. They had given a progesterone challenge test to the private. Totally now it is after 2 years of amenorrhea, they have given progesterone challenge test. And after that, it is 2 years again.
She responded to progesterone 2 years back.
And she was not having any menstruation later on. No, madam. Abdominal examination was normal, madam. Yes, ma'am. Depth of vagina on ultrasonography. I haven't mentioned the things. And vaginal length. Yeah, vagina was there 7 to 8 centimeters, and on passing of sound waves, we have. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Unmarried.
Unmarried. Yes, ma'am. 18 years. Yes, ma'am. There is an algorithm for differential diagnosing this. A patient comes with amenorrhea. First, we can diagnose it by a simple clinical algorithm. I'll try to explain this. When a patient comes, we should first evaluate the height, whether it is short stature or long stature. If it is a short stature, we should consider whether there is visualization or not. If there is no visualization, it may be Turner syndrome or constitutional pituitary delay or hypothyroidism. If there is visualization, it may be Cushing syndrome or congenital adrenal hyperplasia. When it is tall stature with visualization, the probabilities are 17-20 lyase deficiency and aromatase deficiency. And without visualization, it can be testicular feminizing syndrome. And cortisol levels. Cortisol levels are very much elevated in Cushing syndrome, and it is very minimal in congenital adrenal hyperplasia.
So any other condition is there that mimics CAH? Can you?
Yes, ma'am.
Mimics CAH, but it mimics
these are the set of different pregnancies. Adrenal enlargement is seen, so.
The mother during pregnancy, the
yes.
That
yes, ma'am.
So that is not so much extensive as we see in CAH, congenital adrenal hyperplasia.
Okay, ma'am.
And
Second. Thank you, madam. Thank you for providing us.